Journal Entries Found in the Woods, Part 3, by Red Rum Riot. I ended up going into the woods to look for the notes that were mentioned in the last entry. I came back empty-handed, but if I'm being honest, I didn't look too hard. Although I found no notes, I found a trail. One that I've never seen before, like it says in the entries. I didn't end up following it though, because I was losing light fast. This seems impossible. I've been through these woods countless times in the 5 years I've lived in this area. Maybe I'm starting to go crazy too. Entry, Night 7, 5 a.m. I think I finally built up enough courage to go in there. Into the great unknown, as some may call it. The red door is only feet away from me. What am I waiting for? Either he was just here, or I'm going crazy. Okay, I'm going in. It's dark. Really dark. And so cold. The kind of cold that soaks through to your core. I'm ready to get out of here, and I've only been here for a minute or so. Evil and darkness go together like Blair and Murder, She Wrote. She loves that show. I really miss her. I hope she's doing okay. The truth is, she's going to die. And so am I. Sitting around these woods will get you nowhere, trust me. But then again, you're already in too deep. If you've made it this far, there's no turning back. The far side is a part of these woods where a lot of dark stuff happens. Murders, suicides, rituals. You aren't familiar with that area yet, but you soon will be. Once you get there, you either walk away more traumatized than you thought possible, or they'll drag you under and there's no coming back. Note: I did some research, and Murder, She Wrote was a 90s TV show that aired from 1984 to 1996. I'm guessing these entries are very old, much older than I originally thought. But how have they survived this long? Do they just somehow get passed down after one person gave up? As I continue reading these, I'm getting more questions than answers. Entry, Night 8, 3:17 a.m. The Far Side. That's what they call it anyway. It's the deepest part of the woods, a place most people don't dare go near. Some people don't know about what's happened here. They come across it by accident. Most people don't make it out. Those that do won't dare speak of the horrors they came across. It's fairly close to the Elysian, so maybe they're just trying to protect it. They don't know I'm writing this. Don't let them find out. I'll be long gone by the time anyone finds these. Once you've read these, burn the journal. I can't let this information get out. I don't know if I've already said this, but I've hidden notes throughout the woods. You should be able to find them if you look hard enough. I have to go for now. Good luck. Help me. Note: I'm guessing the notes were already found by whoever had these before I did. I also realized that whoever had these before me, if anyone, didn't burn them. I'm not sure what to think anymore. I feel like this is taking over my life. I feel drained. Something has taken a hold of me. The last two journal entries are fairly short. I don't want to give up on this just yet. I feel like it's somehow my destiny to solve what happened. This may be a prank or something, but it doesn't feel like it. The way my emotions and mental state has changed over the past few days says this is very real. I don't know what I've unintentionally gotten myself into. Entry, Night 9, 2:07 a.m. I got away enough to write this. Stay away from them. Stay away from the woods. Stay away from the creek, at least for a little while. Once you feel it's safe, find the notes. Find the notes before they do. This adventure will take time and effort, but you have to do this. You have to save me, please. Entry, Night 10, 4:05 a.m. I'm trapped. I think I'm in the hidden room located somewhere in or near the Elysian. There's handprints on the door, like someone has tried to escape before. They aren't planning to let me out, and they haven't fed me. I don't know how long I'm going to last down here alone like this. I'm so sorry. Note. That's where the entries end. In a way, I wish there was more. After reading the last of these and still being no closer to solving this than when I began, I almost gave up. This all seems too crazy to be true. But something inside of me is telling me that this is for real. I was able to contact a woman who had lived here her whole life. I showed her what I found and told her everything. She seemed worried, almost like she was scared, as if I brought something evil into her home. She got very silent after I asked if she knew anything. She told me about a boy named Ash, which may or may not be the same Ash who wrote these. Apparently, he disappeared shortly after he started acting strange. He would leave his house at all hours of the night. People would see him wandering around. He wouldn't speak a word to anyone for weeks before his disappearance. The detection dog caught his scent, but it led to a dead end in the middle of the forest. They also found a piece of cloth which also had his scent on it. It ended up being a cold case. He was never seen again. I also asked about Blair. Apparently, she disappeared as well, but under different circumstances. People would see her buying really weird things like chains and machetes. She would lock herself in her house and not come out for weeks at a time, and when she did, it was only during the light of day. Eventually, she didn't come out at all. Neighbors began worrying, and when they went to go check on her, she was gone. She left all of her things. It seemed that she left with just the clothes on her back. The police apparently reported that they found chilling drawings all over the walls of her bedroom, but no sign as to where she could have gone. After talking with this woman, I'm pretty frightened. I could have chalked this up to a practical joke or some story someone made up, but now I can't do that. I've tried looking up news articles of Ash's and Blair's disappearances, but I found nothing. Where did they go? Is Ash still trapped somewhere? Did he die? Is Blair still alive, or did they get her too? These are questions that will probably haunt me for the rest of my life. This may or may not be my last update. I was going to give up here, I really was, but I can't. Something won't let me.